Well, good morning to children of St Mary's School and St Helen's School. I hope you're having a really good first week back at school. It's been so great to see so many children back happy and smiling and feeling refreshed after the half-term holiday at St Helen's, and I'm sure it's the same with the children at St Mary's School. I'm delighted this morning to be joined by Howell, and that obviously children of St Mary's will know really well, and for the children at St Helen's, I think you met Howell before, when Miss Hurd and Mr. Adams did an assembly before, because for today's assembly, we know our value is about forgiveness this term, but we've got a very special assembly today, because on Sunday, we have a very special day on Sunday in church with Remembrance Sunday, and then on Wednesday of next week, on the 11th, obviously we will come together somehow to be on the playground, because we normally all come together on the playground for our 2 minute silence, which we understand is so important, and we'll explore a little bit more about that in today's assembly and in classes moving forward. But we will still be carrying on with our 2 minute silence next week, so a bit more of that will come out over the next few days. So I'm delighted to welcome Howell, but as always, as we've done with all our assemblies, we'll start with our welcome words. And so we have gathered as a community today to worship together and think about our value of forgiveness, our new value for this term. And really important, we know all the values that we follow at St. Helens, at St. Mary's are so important, but particularly in this particular time, forgiveness is a really important value. And I know some children in some year groups are actually focusing around peace and conflict. So having just been in the year five classroom today, just seeing a little bit about what they're doing around peace and conflict, which ties in very carefully with today's assembly. So Howell, over to you. Nice to see you. How are you? You okay?
Yeah, not too bad. Not too bad. I was just getting the remembrance service ready for Sunday, because we're not meeting in church. We're doing it virtually on YouTube. So I was just editing the video, ready to upload it, make sure it's kind of okay. And I have to say thank you to all the children, all the people who've made the pebbles outside St. Mary's Church. With poppies on, because they'll be featuring in the video as we do that. But today is all about remembrance and the poppy and what the poppy means. Now you've got a poppy for us, haven't you? Can you hold up?
Yeah, I'll just hold up my poppy. There's our poppy, and we obviously.
There we go. Well done. So basically, we use the poppy to remember, and to remember all those people who died in the First and Second World War. And we use things around us all the time to help us remember things. Not like to kind of remember the information, but just to kind of remind us who we are and why things are important. So I've got lots of things in my study which I use to remind me who I am and remind me of important things. Behind me, you might be able to see, there we are. You might have been able to tell by my accent that I'm Welsh. So I've got a big Welsh flag behind me, which when I'm on Zoom meetings, everybody seems to like, except for one or two. But there we are. So I can remind me every time I'm on Zoom, I can remember that I'm Welsh, and that's important to me. The other thing I like to remember about who I am is I am a total and utter nerd. Some of you know I'm a scientist, but also as well, I'm a total nerd. So what I've got here is my AT-AT model for my Star Wars toys that I still sort of have. So I have that up in my office to remind me that I like Star Wars and I'm a bit of a nerd. And I quite like that. It's quite a lot of fun, like in Star Wars. The other things that I have to remind me, I wear some things to remember who I am as well. So you can't really see, but I have to wear my uniform to show that I'm a priest. So that's why I wear the clergy collar, to remind me of that, so I can remember to behave myself when I'm out in Tesco's, so not get cross with people, especially with this on. And also as well, I'm married, so I go around with my wedding ring, and that reminds me that I'm married. That's the important thing. It reminds me of the commitment that I made. It's a remembering thing. And that's why we have the poppy, and that's why we wear the poppy, is to remind us and to remember about all those people who died so that we could be free, those people who lay down their lives for our country so that we can live in a free country. And my patron saint died during the Second World War. This is, I can tell I must be a total nerd. I've got an action figure saint of Saint Maximilian Colbert, and I've got him up there. See, he's not even out of the box, like, yeah. So, and he died in the Second World War. And when he died, what he did was he gave his life for another person. So one person was going to go and be killed in this prison. And Maximilian Colbert said, no, don't kill this guy because he says he's got a family and I will die in his place. And the wonderful thing with Maximilian Colbert is even though he was under so much pressure and people have been so horrible to him all the time while he was in that prison, he forgave the people who were there, the people who were horrible to him. And through that forgiveness, hope spread throughout that prison. And that's the thing that really inspires me about Maximilian Colbert and inspires me at Remembrance Day as well, is that we can remember not just the horrible things that happened, but we can also remember the heroes of the two world wars and other conflicts and the kindness and the forgiveness that was shown during them as well, because forgiveness and kindness is more powerful than violence and hate. And that's why he's my patron saint. And when we wear the poppy and we see the poppy and we think about remembrance, we can remember the heroes who were kind and good and forgiving, and the heroes who fought for us so that we could be free. So that's why I think that remembrance is important. That's why I think the poppy is important, to remind us of all these different things, far more important even than AT-AT from Star Wars.
Fantastic, Howard. And it's always a very special time, isn't it? Like at this particular time of year with the Remembrance Sunday, and lots of children, you may be watching television in the past and seen huge remembrance services at the Cenotaph in London, where the Prime Minister and in the past royal families have laid wreaths to, as Howard's just been talking about, to remember those people who have fought in First World War, Second World War, but also recent conflicts. And I know some children that I've taught know that I've got two brothers myself who are in the army and that have actually served in conflict. And as we've talked about before, it's not nice things, and it is important to remember those people, but also to forgive, as Howell's been saying. It's an important time. And certainly from a St. Helens point of view as well, there's been so many times I've been proud of our children. And the times over the years that we've gathered on the Key Stage playground, all of us together, to stand in silence for 2 minutes on our Remembrance Day has sent a chill down my body, that the fact that our children have just stood for 2 minutes in beautiful silence, just reflecting, and accept exactly what you're saying, isn't how to think about and reflect. And I think you've got a couple of reflection questions now, haven't you, that you're just going to talk about?
Yeah, that's right. Is in St. Mary's, what we've done is there's a path going up to the church door. And what we've done is we've asked loads of people to take pebbles and to paint them with poppies and little messages about remembrance. And we've got loads and loads of them. They nearly get all the way up to the memorial on the lych gate. There's so many of them. And we've laid them all out on there. And in the video that we've made for Sunday, for Remembrance Sunday, we're going to put them in the video. And what I like some of the children to do is, you know, after school, when they walk out, not all together, be social distanced, but just spend a little bit of time just looking at those pebbles and thinking about them and thinking about that symbol of the poppy as a way of remembering all those people who died. The other good thing to do maybe on the weekend is in the new estate in Northgate called Ladden Garden Village. The streets up there are named after some of the soldiers who died in the First World War. And we've made a remembrance trail. So if you walk around the streets up there, you'll find these signs with information on about the different people who died and where they're buried for each of the streets. So if you go to Reed Road, you can read about Charles Reed, who died in the Battle of the Somme. And that's why it's called Reed Road. And each of those streets is named after one of the soldiers who died in the First World War.
Wow.
So you can go up there and check it out. Yeah. And you can download a trail sheet by going to the parish website, and you can find it on there.
That sounds amazing that you can and then really delve into the history, can't you, behind the names, because that's something that I've done when I've gone to church as part of Remembrance Sunday, is when you stand, you lay your wreath, and you look at some of the names that are on the memorial, the stones, and you wonder where they've come from, what is their background story, how they found themselves to be in those conflicts at that particular time. And for St. Helen's children, that sounds an amazing thing that St. Mary's children have the opportunity to do. And for St. Helen's children, obviously in our own individual classes next week, we'll be reflecting a little bit more as we lead to Remembrance Day on the 11th, on Wednesday. But also as you walk past our church, because like St. Mary's, the church is right outside the school. So it's just a case of you, when you reflect and walk past our school church and walk past the church, to have a little glance at the memorial stone and have a look at those names and think, and if you could come back to me with some of your thoughts, and that would be amazing to really consider the people who obviously have given their lives. How are you happy to finish with a prayer now, and as we all come together at both schools?
Yeah. So let's pray. Lord our God, we thank you for the ways in which we can remember things and the way in which we can act in remembrance. We pray for peace in our world, that we will learn the lessons of the past and be forgiving and peaceful people. And as we are in that Remembrance Sunday, thinking about these different things, may you give us the grace to be people of peace and people of love and people of forgiveness. Amen.
Amen. And normally we finish assembly with a song, and over the past term we were having to either hum that in our heads or sing in our heads, because we're obviously, unfortunately, we're not allowed to sing in big groups. We can only sing in groups of 15 or less. However, we've been talking as teachers at both schools, at St. Helens and St. Mary's, and Mr. Spence has shared with us a very clever plan for how we can probably sing in two groups of 15 within the classroom. So some of the teachers may have their very first go at singing in small groups within the classroom. So it's almost an A-B-A-B type grouping scenario. So some of you may sing the verse, and then the other 15 children may sing the chorus. So it might be that this is the first opportunity for some teachers to be adventurous and have a go at singing within the classroom. So I'll leave that up to the teachers. And hopefully, I know at St. Helens, we're having a little think about whether we can do online singing assemblies as well, because St. Helens children know that I love my singing, and I'm really missing at the moment all the whole school coming together in the hall to be singing. So hopefully we'll be singing as soon as we possibly can together with singing assembly, but 15 children at a time. But how great, fantastic to meet you today, and thank you so much for that. And as we were discussing before we started the recording of this assembly, I remember those attacks very, very well, the Star Wars figures that you had. I one of my favorite things was the Millennium Falcon that I cherished into my younger brothers, the same two brothers actually that are now in the army, would come along and destroy it with the TIE fighters. Was it the Darth Vader TIE fighters that he used
That's
to be
right, in? Yeah.
And then how those things.
But,
but on and more, sorry, how I missed that.
No, I was just saying, the reason I've got this is it's a bit of a sad story, is that when I was a kid, we were too poor because to buy an AT-AT, and my dad bought me Playmobil instead. So to make up for it, my missus bought me that. So I finally had an AT-AT when I was 35. So there you go.
And it's amazing, isn't it, how things come around, because my own children now are just beginning to get into Star Wars and want all the Star Wars figures that I obviously have myself. So I wish I kept those all those years ago. They'd be so valuable now, aren't they, the original thing. Anyway, we digress, but children at St. Helens know I always go off on a tangent anyway. But on a more serious note, as we said, as we come to Remembrance Day and Remembrance services in, obviously on Sunday, and then next week we will start thinking even more so, like today's assembly has done, about our value of forgiveness and as we move to our Remembrance Day next week. Take care, everybody. Have a really, really good rest of the week, and have a great weekend, and keep nice and safe, and keep working really, really hard in both schools. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.
You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.